sending a helicopter to Mars, a busy week for our new administrator, and showcasing how technology enables exploration. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. Our administrator, Jim Bridenstine, announced the U.S. will send the first helicopter to the Red Planet as part of the Mars 2020 rover mission. The small Mars copter will make a series of test flights in Mars' thin atmosphere, which may enable more ambitious missions in the future. Exploring the Moon and Mars was a recurring theme during a busy third week in office for the administrator, including a May 8th industry day at NASA headquarters, where he encouraged companies to respond to NASA's upcoming call for commercial delivery missions to the Moon.
Some of you in this room will deliver payloads to the surface of the Moon. You will increase our national capabilities, and you will help establish our leadership in the world.
We are returning to the Moon with commercial and international partners in support of President Trump's Space Policy Directive 1, which is designed to increase science activities near and on the Moon, ultimately return humans to the lunar surface, and prepare for missions to Mars and beyond.
At some point in the past, Mars changed. We need to understand what caused that, what is the history, so that we can better understand our own planet.
The following day, Bridenstine delivered the keynote at the Humans to Mars Summit 2018 at the George Washington University in Washington. The annual event addresses the technical, scientific, and policy challenges of making human exploration of Mars a reality. On May 9th, our astronaut Randy Bresnik and European Space Agency astronaut Paolo Nespoli joined NASA officials for our Tech Day on the Hill event. The event showcased exhibits from NASA and its industry and academic partners to help demonstrate for Capitol Hill stakeholders and the media the important role technology plays in enabling exploration. We have signed a second Space Act agreement with Uber to further explore concepts and technologies related to urban air mobility, a system NASA and others are working on today to ensure safe and efficient air transportation above the streets of populated areas in the future. Uber will share its plans for an aviation rideshare network, while NASA will use airspace management computer modeling and simulation to assess the impacts of small aircraft in crowded environments. The recent eruptions of Kilauea Volcano on the island of Hawaii were captured by a Japanese-built thermal imager on our Terra spacecraft. The May 3rd eruption triggered a number of additional fissure eruptions along the East Rift Zone. It also produced high levels of sulfur dioxide gas, prompting evacuations in the area. The image shows the gas in yellow and yellow-green, including a massive plume of it moving out over the ocean. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.